Hey guys, Mikeson Gaming here. Now, I'm not going to be playing in this game video. I just want to make this sort of a recap of Sister Location and my thoughts on it. This game was one of the best Five Nights at Freddy's games. And that's kind of saying a lot because there's only six, technically. If you count Fat Florida, which I've never played. I might play it, but that's a might. Only if you guys want me to. But anyways, I have to say, it's kind of up there, but it just can't beat FNAF 2. Or FNAF, well, it's kind of mixed with FNAF 4, but it just can't beat FNAF 2. It's a pretty good game on all. The one thing I feel like this game could have done better is I feel like it should have been a survival basis instead of do as you're told and you'll be fine basis. And I know nothing of the secret ending yet, so I'm saving that for another video. But I'm saving that for when I get a new recording software, which I might get one very soon, actually. But, some things I just wanted to notice or say about this. I noticed that the mini arenas look like they're spelling out baby, and I think they do that because they're still loyal to baby, because I'm pretty sure they're the ones that tore up Laura in Night 3, because you see them holding up, well, I didn't see this before, but you see them holding up Laura's parts, like, as if they ripped them apart. I forgot what I was gonna say. I have seen pictures of Ennard. I know what Ennard completely looks like when he's completely made. I just gotta say, most misleading teaser image ever, because it made it look like Ennard was gonna be a head and then a misformed endoskeleton, kind of like in the sense of Mangle, where it's more of a, because the picture made it look like he had a tentacle kind of body, so like he sort of just moved around as a little robotic thing, but he actually has a full body. And the weird thing is, whenever I see it, it's Funtime Foxy's body. Like, it has Funtime Foxy's physique, but it has like a little more around here. Like, kind of like you mix Freddy's abdomen with Funtime Foxy's body. That's kind of what Ennard's physique looks like, which I think is really weird. And another thing is, like, I don't really think I can sort of see baby's little physique in there. But one thing I definitely noticed about Ennard when I saw him is he actually is the amalgamation of Jump Scare. That's what I call it now because of Mark. The amalgamation of Jump Scare that I showed you guys a screenshot of from one of my videos. Where did that head come from? That's the biggest question I have. Where did that head come from? Because it doesn't match this. It doesn't match this. It doesn't match this. And it doesn't match this. I've seen what's under here. Again, there should be a making more, but where did Ennard's head come from? It's the jaw mainly is what I'm focused on. I just noticed its jaw is completely different. It's like if you have Freddy's, but it's more round and more pointy. Not like Ballora's super sharp teeth, but like Freddy's flat teeth. So I like that kind of deal. I have figured out what these things are. I've made a rant about it in my last video for this location. This was the plush trap hallway. This was the map. And this was the bedroom. All from FNAF 4. And another thing I think is interesting that I noticed is that lamp that you have in your room is the lamp from FNAF 4. Also, I never figured out who's using these cameras. It seems like a detail I'd have in there. Also, I think people are overlooking the fact that the fan is clearly taken over. The fan has clearly taken over and become more than a desk fan. Oh, yeah. Fun memories of fixing Freddy and Bonnie. So in night two, I assumed, we immediately went to, it was Bonnie's voice I was playing when we played the master on you. And then I eventually was like, oh wait, that's probably Freddy's speaker. But I'm pretty sure that actually was Bonnie. I think I'm playing the mic way too close to my mouth. Okay, anyways, I made the assumption that it was Bonnie. I later thought that it was this. I think it actually is Bonnie. Because you hear another voice. Like, I think that's Freddy. And I think that's Freddy's voice from this thing. So, is Bonnie girl? I don't know. I think I'm strong to my opinion that Bonnie's a guy. But Toy Bonnie and Puppet Bonnie are a little questionable. God, my voice is crashing so much lately. It's just a little questionable. Fair, I was gonna say there. So now what these things are. Wait a minute. Where are the buttons? Hey, I just noticed that. The buttons aren't here. There should be buttons. You guys know what I mean, right? The buttons just shock and turn on the turn on the lights and shock the animatronics. Why are those not here? It's so weird. Oh yeah, fans clearly taking over. There's something else I was gonna say, but it's slipping my mind. I'll come back when I think of it. Oh wait, yeah, never mind. No, I'm not gonna cut this out. I almost immediately thought of it. This is something I can't believe I didn't notice before, because I am a guy who notices these, not always notices the smallest details, but can notice the smallest details, and will notice a lot of things. But I'm such a doof, because I didn't notice this. You get where I'm going at, or do I have to say it? Like a doof. I did not notice that. I don't know how I didn't notice this, but baby's eyes are green. Baby's eyes are blue. I know what this is. I know this is a child who bit or who was attacked by baby and put into the suit on. The girl is haunting her, and then that's why Ennard's eyes are blue, because they probably went back to their original color, which is this, like we see in the little corner here. Hey, little baby. You know what? I'm gonna try this actually. Let's see if I can do it. Oh god. I forgot the controls completely. I'm losing Bible time. Nope, I'm clearly terrible. Okay, just a quick thing I want to say. What didn't get posted, unfortunately, was a 5-hour-long video of me and Harmar trying to beat that stupid minigame for 5 hours. It was so dumb. I really wanted to post it, but the video was corrupted. I was so sad. 5 hours of what you just saw. 5 hours of it. Oh, that's 5 hours I'd like to get back. That's 5 hours of my life I'd like to get back. There's one small, like, not really a complete theory, I gotta say. It's because it's not, like, something I actually think is true. It's just a little thing I, like, thought of at the time, and it's like, oh, that would be cool if it was true. But it's most likely not. In the end scene, you see your character move across the screen, and in the mirror, he opens his eyes, and they're purple. Ballora's eyes are, in fact, purple. At one point, I just, like, made a silly little theory. I was like, hey, imagine if, like, when Eddard scooped you, Ballora just came in there, took the body, like, bye, and just ran off. Because, like, I was like, well, think about it, Ballora is right outside the door, and Eddard is on the other side of the glass. Eddard would have to go all the way around the building to get out and into that room. And Ballora's just right there. Also, Eddard's huge. Eddard's like 7'4", I believe. If Baby is 7'2", Eddard should be like 7'4". I know Purple Guy's a big person, but come on. Come on. I think that's a little bit of a stretch. So imagine if like Ballora's and this guy was in there, because the book said like his skin was like saggy or something like that. I haven't read the book completely, I've just read highlights of it. Also, I watch Game Theory. Also, Baby's freaking giant. If anyone knows how to get those Easter egg screens, please tell me. How do you get the Easter egg screens with the blueprints? That's the one I would want to know the most. I know you can get one of Lolbit, I know you can get one of Fredbear and the skeleton. Man, that was annoying me for a while. And I know you can go with blueprints. I forgot the others. If there even is others. Yes. So yeah. If anyone knows how to get those, please, please comment. And Gary, if you're watching this, if you know anyone who might have any clue what I'm talking about, please tell them about like my channel and stuff like that. And like, because I just want to know how to get those blueprints. MathPath said that like currently there's no one knows how to get to them. I think I was thinking of saving that for a live stream, maybe. But who'd do live stream? Who'd be awake from 12 to 5, or anywhere in that time doing a live stream? I don't think so. So, but I do want to know why I can get that, because I noticed some interesting things. Baby's a giant. Baby's 7'2". She's bigger than Ballora. This is not a closer picture from, or not a closer camera view. This is all to scale. This is as big as that, bigger, actually. My god. Just look at that. That's crazy. Baby, it's huge. So yeah, all in all, it was a good game. I I feel like it could have done a little better. I was kind of hoping for, like, you have to move around the rooms, and, like, maybe sometimes you'd have, oh, let me get the blueprint out, so it's easy to say this. Okay, so, like, maybe in here you could, like, view them, and, like, also, like, have to hide someplace sometimes. Like, if you, like, Foxy, like, sometimes, like, they'll be all walking around. And for maybe, like, Freddy, if he's ever near, you could, like, hide, and maybe use the voice on him to make him go away. Or Foxy, you just have to make sure you completely don't move until he walks away or something like that. And, like, or Laura, you just have to shut the freak up and let her just go. But, and, like, go through the vents to escape. But, like, I wasn't really expecting this at all. I want to know who was, actually. Who was expecting this, other than Scott Coughlin? Surely it was not me. There was a lot of story to gain from this, but at the same time, it's all... What do you really know about it? We really don't know squat about this series. We really don't know anything about the series at all. One question has been haunting my mind. What real mystery is there? That has been haunting me forever. Because there's no real question we can ask. It's all just, we just don't know. That's the problem. We just don't know. There is one question I would like to ask. Who is the crying child haunted? Who is the crying child haunted? Haunting! Who is the crying child haunting? There we go! So, is it Fredbear after all? Is it not? I don't know. And there's also this little small theory I'd like to tag up on. I'm just gonna go ahead and put it on Freddy, because... I feel like it was almost completely confirmed with the whole suit thingy and Fredbear. And those skulls and Easter egg. I had a theory that they were trying to bring back Fredbear and Spring Molly. But I'm going to change that a little bit. Before, it was a theory that they're trying to bring back Fredbear and Spring Bonnie because they liked them. Like, the company liked them, the children liked them, so they wanted to bring them back. But I'm going to change that a bit. I think Afton himself is trying to bring back Fredbear and Spring Bonnie, because in the teaser, we see Baby, the one where it's just Baby's face, you see her nose has a reflection of what looks like Spring Bonnie. So people jumped at the opportunity, oh, this is probably like somewhere around 1987 or something like that. Also, this is actually after all the games. I think Afton is trying to bring back Fredbear and Spring Bonnie so he can stick to his way of getting things done. Because his way is to use the decommissioned Fredbear and Spring Bonnie suit and lure children and kill them. But I contradict myself with the fact that he's making these murder bots. Because, like... I forgot what I was going to say. But yeah, like, I feel like I'm almost contradicting myself because he's making these murder bots to do this stuff for him. Maybe he just also wants to do stuff, too. I don't know. But anyways, that was my closing thoughts on this game. I still haven't seen the secret ending. All I know is, what the heck? Okay, I just looked away for a second, because it looks like... Freddy's eyes had a really weird shade of blue going on there. Like, it has like purple and pink in the middle. But anyways, crap, what was I gonna say? Anyways, this was all just all around a good game. These are my closing thoughts on it. I don't know anything of the secret ending, that's what I was gonna say. I don't know anything of the secret ending except for how to beat it and what happens in the mini game. That's all I know, and it's kind of horrific screaming, by the way. The screaming is very haunting. You know what, I'm gonna give it one more go and then I'm gonna call quits.
Crap.
one more time. I don't have enough time to screw up. One more time. Forgetting about that one cupcake. One more time. hate this game so much. Everything's fine, I'm just raging on my game.
You sure?
Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah. This All game's right. just screwing me over.
Alright.
But I hate this game right now. really hate this game right now. God! I just got out of... That was so close! 1 second off! God dang it! I was right there! Dang it! Anyways guys, that was my dad who just came in. Dang it. I was so close. Excuse me while I throw my computer against the wall. This is my life right now. Anyways guys, this has been Mike Is in Gaming. This has been Sister Location, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Later.